Australia is set to strengthen a four-nation alliance with America, India and Japan to counter China's growing threat to our region. The Prime Minister will hold historic talks with US President Joe Biden and the other leaders this weekend.
The vaccinator-in-chief. Casting an eye over his priority project.
What are we doing?
Domestic and international vaccine diplomacy. On Saturday morning, the Prime Minister will talk with India's Narendra Modi, Japan's Yoshihide Suga and US President Joe Biden, four nations that form the Quad.
And that is an anchor of peace and stability in the region.
The first leaders' meeting will focus on boosting vaccine production in the region to supply Southeast Asian nations, but the Quad's main aim is protecting against the threat of China.
It's not a mini UN of four nations. That's not what it is. This is about four like-minded countries.
Countries which have eyes on regional security issues like Beijing's military expansion in the South China Sea, its threats over Taiwan, its crackdowns in Hong Kong and trade sanctions on Australian goods over a long list of grievances.
That President Biden has made this one of his earliest multilateral engagements speaks to the importance we place on close cooperation.
And another nation who knows what it's like to live in the shadow of Beijing is in step with the Prime Minister.
Australia is not walking alone.
China has warned the Quad not to undercut Beijing, although its relationship with Canberra couldn't get much colder. Domestically, the Prime Minister has other challenges. JobKeeper is about to end, and the Reserve Bank Governor has warned unemployment could rise.
There are still many people who want a job who can't find one.
Philip Lowe also warning surging house prices pose another risk to an economic recovery still fragile.
We are watching carefully. There is still a long way to go.
And Pete, Nine News understands tomorrow morning the federal government will unveil a multi-billion dollar package for industries which will suffer most when the JobKeeper wage subsidy ends at the end of the month. Aviation and tourism are at the top of the list. The package could be delivered in a number of ways. It might include something like discounted airfares and a retention payment to keep workers on board, which is essentially a continuation of JobKeeper in a more targeted form. Pete, these industries need to be kept alive until the vaccine rollout allows them to fly solo again.
All right, Jono, thank you.